host, and welcome to Mehdi's Tech Circle. First of all, I wish you a happy new year. Stay healthy, and I wish you really all the best for the year 2019. So in this video, we want to take a look at the official OneUI beta. So in my last video on Monday, I just announced that the OneUI is out. And yeah, in this video, I want to report how my experience was with the official OneUI update and how the battery life is, stability, and talk maybe, or just give you again, because I have done this before in my beta reviews, I will give you an overview of the biggest changes, the most noticeable changes in the OneUI update. So you can also leave in the comments down below suggestions on what my next video should be, so what you want to see about the OneUI update, and yeah, just leave that as a comment down below. I will read that. And yeah, so let's start. So I have done a factory reset when the official OneUI update came out. I have done a factory reset because I was on beta before, so I was on Oreo, of course, and then I joined the beta program. I got beta 1, beta 2, then a hotfix for beta 2, beta 3, and then beta 4. So I got so many updates, and then it's time to clean everything up, to just do a factory reset. Sometimes it will just improve performance, battery life, and so on. So you don't have to do this, except if you are upgrading over the air and you see that you have really bugs that are annoying you, then the best way to fix these bugs is to do a factory reset. So how is the performance? So since beta 1, the performance was no issue for me personally. So I never noticed any lags, hiccups. Of course, beta 1 was more unpolished than the last beta, beta 4. That's normal because, I mean, they had time to polish things up. The OneUI is not completely finished. So that is something you have to remember. It's not completely finished. I will tell you later why. But yeah, the performance is pretty good. So yeah, no hiccups, no lag. Yeah, animations are smooth. Really, I didn't notice anything negative about the performance. So it's pretty good. And I would say also much smoother feeling than Oreo was. Yeah, how is the battery life? Battery life is really good. So this is an Exynos SMG 965F. And if you know that the, or if you are longer in the Samsung community, you will know that the Exynos models always had battery issues. They weren't as good optimized as the Snapdragon models, which are sold in the US and I think also in China. I don't really know. But performance is surprisingly pretty good after the factory reset. Of course, the first day after factory reset or after updating, the first day, the second day, sometimes it takes a week that the battery settled down and is learning your usage pattern and so on. Also, because we have now, if we go to the battery setting here, you will see that we have now this adaptive battery thing, and it learns your usage pattern, how you will learn your how you will use your phone. And yeah, I can show you my battery life history. So I unplugged 22 hours ago, and I have approximately 9 hours 35 minutes left. What is, yeah, I don't know if that's right. 3 hours and 29 minutes of screen on time, but I don't care that much now of screen on time. The main thing is that the phone should last as long as I need. So when it lasts a day, it's pretty good. So I'm really not expecting 7-8 hours really of screen on time. It is possible, but then you just have to stay on your phone and don't put it in in standby, and so just don't care too much about screen on time. The main thing is that there's nothing which is draining your battery crazy, like, I don't know. But it lasts good. Everything is fine with the battery. So that's good. It could be better, maybe. For example, Android system, 10% of drain, battery drain. This could be maybe improved. I don't know, but it's okay. It's not that my battery would drain like in 8 hours. It's empty after a moderate usage, so that's okay. And basically, you have all these goodies like the new multitasking view. By tapping here on an icon, you can select things like app info or lock this app. On supported apps, you can also open it in pop-up view or in split screen mode. You have here your suggested apps, which you can disable here under settings and suggested apps. You can disable this. What do I want to show you? And of course you have here your gestures. Here you can select it over the quick toggle, and boom, you have now gesture control. But I am testing out how it is with the navigation bar. It's yeah, I don't know. I just testing out how it is to use it with the nav bar, because I used it a lot since the beta with gestures. Then you have here this completely new redesign. All Samsung apps are optimized for one-handed mode. So here on the top you have this I don't know how they call it, I think info area, and here is the interactive area. So for example, if you open up notification settings and you want to go to the setting here to app icon badge, and you are holding it with one hand, you don't have to stretch here. You just pull it down and boom, you see? Boom, you can now reach it easily with one hand. That goes for everything else here. So always you can pull it down also when you go here, for example. So that's pretty nice. This also works in apps like Samsung Notes. Here you can see, boom, and you want to reach out, bam, you just pull it down to you. So this is really nice. I love this, what Samsung has done with the One UI. That's one of my favorite things in the One UI. Also, you can see here with the quick toggles, you can reach easily everything you need. That's amazing. That's nice. And the next thing is you have night mode. You can switch everything here. All the Samsung UI in a dark theme, which looks pretty good at night. Then you have standard Pi features like adaptive battery, this thing here where you can scroll through your apps and multitask pretty fast. And then, for example, also with the auto rotate thing that it locks, and if you tap this here, this icon, it goes in landscape and it stays in landscape until you just tap again on this icon. This works also with the navigation gestures, but then you will have to need to enable the hints for the navigation gestures, or the gesture usage here. But yeah, then you have scene optimizer. So here things are from coming to the S9 from the Note 9. For example, also flaw detection. If a photo you have taken is blurry, it will give you a notification of that you have taken a blurry shot. Then Bixby Home is completely new. We have Bixby 2, which you can then set to enable by double tapping the Bixby key, so you doesn't or don't accidentally open it up. You have so many things, redesigned icons. I can dive deeper in all these changes in One UI in another video, but this should just give you an overview on how the official One UI update is running, so that you know that I'm running the official one. You can see here my build number, that is CRLI, that's the official One UI update. So don't ask me when does it come, when you are getting it. So it was rolled out to the Netherlands, to Italy, to Germany, to the United Arab Emirates, to Switzerland, but also just unlocked phones. If you have a phone from T-Mobile, Vodafone, or I don't know which carrier exists, there are many carriers, but they will push it later in stages. They have test the software internally, and then they roll out it for their carrier branded devices. US didn't receive the official One UI yet, but it should come soon. I hope so for my friends in the US. And again, just because I mentioned it earlier in this video, the One UI is still not finished. There was a beta notice, and they told us what will come with later updates. So for example, they will add a schedule for night mode. For example, now you can just turn it on or off, but they will add a schedule. For example, leaked Pi builds or One UI firmware for the S8 and Note 8 already have the schedule in, but it will add this for the S9 and S9 Plus soon. They will bring back this dot here you had on the nav bar to hide the nav bar. So if you are a fan of using the nav bar instead of gestures and you want to hide it in some apps, you can do that by double tapping then this dot. They will bring this also back, and they will still change minor things in One UI. So for example, the schedule for night mode and this with the nav bar and other things I don't remember now. They will bring this app back with, I think, like security patches, for example, with the January security patch or the February security patch. They could bring this back as part of this security update. So yeah, that was my review, and yeah, just to give you an impression on what to expect with the official One UI update. So is it worth to install? Yes, definitely. So this really is worth it. All these changes, this new fresh redesign, this gives you really the feeling to have a new phone, and it just runs amazing for me. And yeah, so that was my review about the One UI, the official One UI update. Again, leave me in the comments what you want to see about the One UI and suggest me on what to do my next video. I hope you have a fantastic day, guys. See you soon here on Mehdi's Tech Circle. And again, Happy New Year to all my fellows. Thanks for your support. Bye. Take a body's high.